I love you, man.
I love you. And the beat goes on,
you know, and the beat goes on. It's MTV Sports, it's coming at you. It's Dan and Darren, watch out because we're causing trouble.
This week, step off, highball, dynamic duo, safe surf, doom man, hot wild.
Dude, look who's right behind you. The original Easy Rider, Peter Fonda. Turn around.
We about to go low riding. Low
riding. Dan Cortez, MTV Sports. How you doing, Peter?
Just fine.
It's Luke, Darren. That's one of my bikes. I'm thinking about taking one of the LAPDs. The last time I saw you, you were barefoot water skiing. Give me any tips today? This is my first love ride.
Don't look into the sun.
Keep your feet on the pegs.
I have to get the whole biker outfit before I can actually get on the Harley, right?
It's really a sex thing.
It's a rap thing.
You know what the rap jumping is? You know what that's all about?
No, what is it?
Rap jumping. It's like this. You see me jumping, my back is slipping. Something like that. It's stupid. You know what rappelling is?
No.
Oh, yeah. We about to make you jump.
It's like the reverse of rappelling, except they're going forward. What do you say we go down to Australia and do that?
I say don't believe a word he says. I'm on to him.
Are you ready?
I think so. Let's go.
Earth Solo Thrill.
G'day, from Australia.
You can do it. Don't let anybody tell you that you can't.
Rap jumping is a forward form of rappelling, really, where you hook up on a harness, jump down on a rope face first. Most climbers around the world think that descending is just a matter of getting down. Whereas we've actually turned it around and used it as a sport.
There's about 400 billion trillion cliffs in this country that are ready to be wrapped off. But you're in control yourself. You're taking your limitations as far as you can take it. We put the thing on like so.
Next to my personality, this is the best sort of contraceptive you can ever get.
The biggest skill lies in up the top, up in your mind, that you got to sort of focus on that you're going to go down that cliff, and it's the big challenge that you sort of put to yourself.
When you take the first step in rap jumping, you're only one step closer to the bottom. You've still got a hell of a long way to go. We're trying to go as far and as fast as we can.
Like, most people are scared of the bottom where you land down, because that's why you're going to get hurt. So I think if you sort of put your mind into it, maybe look with a bit more than just your eyes, you won't get as scared. It becomes addictive. You gotta do it so, like, to get your system going.
We all hooked up?
You all very well.
G'day, USA.
And guess what? He's Aussie! Yeah!
Every jump's different on this cliff face. The best jump you can ever do is a safe jump.
You like jumping. You like shouting now.
See, y'all wouldn't want to be y'all.
Stick him! That was the rap jumping in Australia.
Get out on the highway.
Look out for the trailer. Born to be run over. Oh, get off the bike. You know what? All right. Say something to your mom. Say, hey, mom.
Hey, mom.
Hey, what's coming up next? Highlight.
Nerdissa.
It's like 150. Do you know what the ball's called?
No, it goes about 150 miles.
Though. 150 miles an hour. It's called a pelota, man. It's French and Spanish. It's like we, see?
I got you!
Okay. All right. We're bilingual.
Fucking bilingual.
You go ahead. I'm going to thumb. I'm out of gas. Maybe I should show a little leg.
Oh, yeah?
You're going to hook me up.
Earth Group Competition.
You have to be able to control the ball that comes to you toward you, maybe 140 miles an hour, 150 miles an hour.
Highlights is a paramutual sport.
People gamble on you every day.
Wait a lot.
It's a game similar to racquetball. The ball has one bounce, or you can catch it in the air.
Fastest game you can play with a ball.
Pelota. A little harder than a baseball and about 3/4 the size.
Throwing with a basket that's curved.
Cesta.
The curve makes a big difference whether the ball goes up or down.
You know, you play the round robin. One plays the two, two to three, and so forth.
Boom, shakalaka, boom.
Eight teams, two players on a team. To 7 points.
They're watching the game, which lasts approximately 15-20 minutes.
Some players throw hard.
Remate.
A couple years back, I threw the ball somewhere between 180 and 190. Some players finesse it. They'll run you around and they'll catch one more ball than you.
There's so much spin involved in the balls, so much movement, so much positioning. The motion is so complex that if one thing is off, the throw will not be good.
I got hit in about 1984. The ball was, I don't know, maybe coming 130 miles an hour, and he tipped it. And the angle was different, and I got hit right in the face. It's plastic, all that.
It's not easy. People think it's easy, but it's tough. It's real tough.
I will give you 20 tries to hit the front wall. Just hit it. You don't have to catch the ball. You don't have to do anything. And we are very sure you probably will not hit the front wall. That's just throwing the ball to the big green area. I mean, even at our situation here, we've been playing for so many years, we're still learning. Every day you're learning.
I'm looking at the Love Ride to get in shape.
I feel like the Pope.
Coming over this freeway out here, the migration, I felt like I worked both my biceps and triceps.
There you go. MTV Sports, very
MTV
hard.
MTV Sports, you're great.
Oh, I got bugs in my teeth.
Hey, when you put me on Entertainment Tonight?
Probably.
All right.
Next on MTV Sports, go AWOL and stop traffic with Inline Skating's original odd couple, Doug Boyce and Bruce Action Jackson. Flippers pissed and seeking the pollution solution with the Surf Rider Foundation's first annual gathering of the oceanic tribes. It's one down and five up for Air Bradshaw, dune flying in Palm Springs, California. Go hog wild with outlaw bikers Dan and Darren at the Love Ride 9.
Oh, did you say when?
Yes.
Or will you?
When?
Monday soon enough?
Good enough for me.
Bye.
How you guys doing? These people behind me? Oh, people who like to ride Harleys, huh? Hey, Darren, what are you doing? Wake up. And me, I'm the person who don't know how to ride a Harley. That's why I'm sitting in the chair. Oh, yeah. This is like staying home from work and still getting a full day's pay, huh, Darren? Hello. We're back, MTV Sports, Love Ride 9. We're Dan the Man, Goggles, Python, Puts No Hands. And my boy Darren Burrows from Northern Exposure.
Loving you, babe.
He'll be exposing himself a little bit later. Coming up next, we got AJ Jackson and Doug Boyce. The inline odd couple, the Ebony and Ivory of the Inline Skating World.
Boom, we are inline skaters, and we gonna bust it.
Bust it. Dun, 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 dun,
dun, dun. They're coming at you like I'm coming at you right now. How you like me now?
Solo Thrill.
Inline extreme roof skating, you gotta do it. Peep this shot out.
Yeah, roof skating, man. Ones are going like that, the steeper the better.
You go to bed, you dream, like, what can I do tomorrow to make this a little bit more intense? You know, street skating, man, you know, rolling down the streets of California,
being
man.
Chased by dogs, cops.
All kind of, man, there was a dog biting on my foot. Man, street style. Some of that funky grooving in and out of cones.
traffic's coming this way, you're weaving it into that way, you know, and then the parking meters, and then the, you know, the parking curbs, you know, there's all kinds of things to weave. Of adrenaline, blood pumps, speeding high, fast speed, not fear, but gearing, flowing fast, not slow, but quickly, fast enough to keep your eyeballs gazing, amazement, say, damn, that boy is crazy.
And you know, I like that dance and stuff. We're gonna do it till the day we die, man, you know? Whatever we do from here on out, boom, we are inline skaters and we gonna bust it, cause that's what time it is.
You know what? We're taking a break right now because AJ and Doug scared the crap out of me. Did they scare you?
Excuse me?
AJ and Doug, did they scare you?
I'm not exactly in the mood for Mozart and all that kind of goings on.
What's coming up next? The Surfrider Foundation.
It's a party with a conscious message.
There are a bunch of surfers trying to do something about saving the ocean. Like the Love Riders trying to do something about muscular dystrophy.
It's a love thing.
It's the first annual State of the Ocean Address. And you know what? I'm nowhere near an ocean, are we, Russ? Honk the horn!
Water group form.
Surfrider Foundation started in 1985, and it was a group of surfers that banded together to stop destructive development that would wreck Malibu Surfing Beach.
It's the gathering of the oceanic tribes.
It's a party with a conscious message.
Uniting to keep Mother Ocean alive.
It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the
Everyone's got to wake up and know that, you know, our ocean's precious and it's not going to be around much longer if we keep treating it the way we do.
Save the ocean!
It's the end.
Probably the main thing that we're doing against the ocean is called non-point source pollution. Whatever we pour down in the gutters goes directly to the ocean.
The ocean's dying right now, and it's gross to surf in. It smells. People are getting sick.
Last year, over 2,000 American beaches were closed when pollution got dumped into the ocean, became unfit for humans to even go in the water.
It's our beach, it's our world.
Look at the world, it's a complicated place. And it's hard to keep the face. You've got to wear a smiling face. Peace and Love Incorporated.
What we're trying to do is just preserve a little bit of what Mother Nature gave us for the future.
Looks like Darren broke down, man. Darren, you broke down?
Break it, damn.
Wait a sec. Try it now.
Yeah.
Motorcycle 101.
All right, Darren, I found a problem, dude. It's the,
Yeah.
Better. He's out again.